We're looking for a band name because we had the most awful names on the planet with the three of us. So we had mentioned from stage all night if anybody had a cool idea for a band name. And a buddy of ours just said, man, you should be called Rascal Flatts. And we were like, what's it mean? And he said, well, I don't know. It was the name of our garage band back in the 60s. So we were like, well, we'll try it. So that's, and it worked.
Well, it stuck, didn't it?
It did.
I think everybody's ready for the music. You guys ready to pick and sing?
We're ready.
Okay. Gary LaVox, everybody, take it away, my friend.
Thanks, hon.
In an old cottonwood tree, signed a bunch of high school yearbooks so they wouldn't forget about me. It wasn't till I saw my daddy's name in stone I knew it ain't a question of if they will, it's how they remember you. Did you stand or did you fall? Build a bridge or build a wall? How'd you love or give it all?
Everybody, hope this is a song that you remember. It's called Fast Cars and Freedom. Here we go.
See what I see, yeah, when it's gone. take me back. I'm on that gravel road. Look at me on my way to pick you up. You're standing on that front porch looking just like that. You remember that? Well, I see a dusty rail following an old red Nova. Baby blue eyes, your head on my shoulder.
Y'all, thank you so much for making this song such a huge part of the biggest days of your life. Hopefully you enjoy it. It's called God Bless the Broken Road.
I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, and I wiped my brow, but I kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. Just smile and take my hand. Oh, you've been there. and I got blessed.
Be a better song in this place, and your audience out there, guys, great job. Gary, they're
thanks,
going crazy.
Thanks. I see them.
We got a lot of people that are writing in. Please get on your computers, on your laptops, whatever you're using, and ask a question of Gary, because we're right here. We're live. We'd love to chat with you. But I want to talk a little bit about this new road. We just talked about Rascal Flatts, or we just heard Rascal Flatts, the last 20 years of your life. Now this transition to Christian music, how did this happen for you in your heart when you decided this is a road I want to go down?
You know, I've always wanted to. Yeah, I mean, everybody'd ask when, you know, Flatts and stuff are like, we'd love to hear you guys do a Christian record, you know. Yeah. So growing up in the church and all that, it's just always been a passion of mine. But I mean, literally going 100 miles an hour for 20 years and mm-hmm. meeting deadlines and everything. So mm-hmm. and all of the tragedy of the pandemic and COVID-19, I actually had the time to really do it, you know, and really write and focus. And this is the song that we're going to do. The first one we're going to do is a song called The Distance, which was the first song that I wrote with McVee and Josh Hogue for this project. And it was just, you know, it's always been in my heart. I mean, I've never been ashamed of my faith mm-hmm. and, you know, it's always been out there. So now I just get to sing about it on a different level. And it's time, and God's timing is perfect, and it was just the perfect time, and I couldn't be more excited about it. So
we are too. If you love gospel music, Christian music, to hear your voice singing for Him is just a blessing to me. We got some people that want to ask him questions, and then we're going to get right back to the music. Are you good with that? You mentioned The Distance. Courtney Campbell wants to know, what was your inspiration behind the song?
The Distance was, you know, it was right. We kind of wrote it like in the beginning. The COVID thing was just starting to happen. And I knew that last year in 2020 that I was going to start on it. Didn't know how much I'd get done. But so this was the first song that we wrote for it. And it was just a song of hope. I'm like, you know, it just made sense that it never quit. This too shall pass. And it just felt like the right thing to write about that. You know what? I mean, we're looking for, at that point, was everything was so up in the air in the world about, you know, do you have to vaccine? This is closed mask. Oh, you know, nobody really knew. And I was like, you know, I mean, the whole thing is our hope is on the cross. So, you know, it just felt right. So it was really about just hope and never quitting, everybody losing their jobs and everything else. So it was just to put some fire into people's soul to go, you know what, it's going to be all right. Sometimes you just have to surrender.
That's right. That's exactly right. So a couple more questions, if you will. Michelle wants to know, when did you start your journey following Christ? How old were you?
I was young, you know, so I grew up in a Pentecostal church. So my grandmother and I was little, you know, Wednesday, twice on Sunday.
You were there every night of the week, Mr. Bell.
Oh, yeah, if I wanted to be or not. Tissues and Juicy Fruit. We rolled up in there. So, yeah, I've always had a solid foundation.
Right. Yes. Katie wants to know, Katie Coles wants to know, what do you hope to achieve the most on your new journey?
You know, I think just The only thing that I really want to achieve is, this success of bringing Jesus to the forefront and putting it in the minds of people and just planting seeds of heaven, for heaven. That's it. It's the only goal is to, this pandemic, I think, has really put life in perspective for everybody on what's important, family and faith. And I think it really put all the little small things that we dealt with up until 2020 really didn't matter, as much as we thought. So I really just want to, sing about the Lord, and, there's nothing worth losing eternity over. So that's where I want to be, and I just want to sing about it. I just want to sing about how great He is.
I don't want to stop you. Are you ready to keep going?
I'm ready.
Here in the Mother Church.
Come on.
All right. Gary Glory. The Vox.
Hey, y'all, this is my brand new song. It's called The Distance. There's a beauty in the struggle. There's help when there's trouble. There's a God that's in your rubble that'll go and pick you up. There's a grace among the sin. There's a fight that you will win. There's a life at the end, but only through Jesus. This song is called Working on Sunday. Lord, it's been a while
innocence, I pray. And I'm hoping that I'm not too late. See, we fought and she left. I call and I text, but she won't answer me. So I'm down on my knees. I know how you feel about working on some.
Hey, y'all, I'm so excited about this next song. It's called A Little Love with one of my dear, dear friends, the lead singer of Mercy Me. Give it up for my brother, Bart Millard. Here we go. What about it, brother?
Man, not much.
You ready?
I hope so.
Here we go. This song's on the new Mercy Me record. Comes out April 30th.
With the weight of the world moving forward, but we're stuck in reverse. Got a head full of headlines, a heart full of doubts, but we gotta change tomorrow right now. Oh, with a little love, 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 but tomorrow it's a tidal wave.
Hits the streets in May, right?